Namaste, Sri Guru Bhyo Namaha. My name is Mahesh. In this video, I would like to tell about three important concepts. Point number one, centripetal acceleration. Point number two, centripetal force. Point number three, resultant acceleration in a circular motion. These three concepts I would like to cover in this video, in which point number one, centripetal acceleration. What is centripetal acceleration? An acceleration acting on an object undergoing uniform circular motion is called centripetal acceleration. Once again, acceleration which is acting on an object undergoing uniform circular motion is called centripetal acceleration. It is always acts an object along the radius and towards the center of the circular path. I can draw a diagram to make you understand. Point number one, centripetal acceleration. Centripetal acceleration. In this centripetal acceleration, first I can give a brief, after that I can give the notes. Okay, now take a circle. It is the center, it is the radius. We want centripetal acceleration, which is always acting towards the center. That means A, C towards the center, or A or, that means because it is a radius, acting along the radius. Once again, centripetal acceleration which can be defined as, it is an acceleration acting on an object. It is an object acting on an object undergoing uniform circular motion is called centripetal acceleration. It is always acting on an object along the radius towards the center. Along the radius towards the center is called centripetal acceleration. Okay, now whatever I explain, I can elaborate on the word. Please observe carefully.
Centripetal force formula
law, F is equal to M square by R, or F is equal to M omega square R. That also I can explain. Okay, slowly on the board. Please observe carefully. Now, I would like to explain about centripetal force. Let's go for discussion. Centripetal force, we can be written as F. Okay? F. Or FC. Centripetal, FP. Both are same. I can explain. Centripetal force is the force which is required to move an object along the radius and towards the center. Therefore, the centripetal acceleration C dot F, centripetal force is equal to FP is equal to MV square by R. That is equal to M omega square R. Okay? Now, I can derive this one, how it came. Okay? Now, observe carefully. Now, I would like to explain how the resultant acceleration in non-uniform circular motion. Let's come to the discussion. Now, take a circle. Okay? Now, this is the radius. This is the radius. This is the center row. Therefore, this is we can call as force F. This force we can call as F. Which force? That is centripetal force. Okay? That means the centripetal force Fp is equal to mv square by r or mr omega square. Okay? Now, at the same time, what is the acceleration here? The acceleration here is, take a circle, the acceleration we can call as A R. Okay? Now, but where is the particle motion direction? This is the particle. vertical motion direction or velocity direction. That means it is the tangent. Where is the velocity? There must be acceleration. Okay? That means it is the velocity direction. Obviously, what is the acceleration direction? In the same direction only. That means take a circle, take 0, it is A or it is acceleration tangent. Okay? Acceleration tangent. Now tell me, where is the resultant? This is the resultant. This is the resultant. Okay? Now, how we can derive that one? Now take that one here like this. This is A radius. A radius. Okay. A radius. Okay? Now, this is A tangent. A tangent. Now consider, it is resultant. Now, I draw a vector like this. Consider, it is hypotenuse. Therefore, it is also AR. AR. Now tell me. Now tell me, from this one, do we know that? This one. This is A resultant. Therefore, A resultant is equal, what is this one? According to Pythagoras theorem, AT square plus AR square. Therefore, A square. A is equal, or A resultant is equal, AR square plus AT square. Okay? Like that, the resultant. Resultant is given by A resultant is equal root of AR square plus AT square in a non-uniform circular motion. Like that, we are of course going to derive. However, I hope this video you understood. Thank you very much for watching this video. Please copy the same concept with your beautiful handwriting in your notes. Thank you very much for watching this video.